Hello everyone, my name is Owen and I work for Amphibian and Reptile Conservation as an Education Officer. Within Amphibian and Reptile Conservation, I work on a project called Snakes in the Heather, and my main aim as an Education Officer is to explain some of the things that make snakes and lizards such fascinating animals. The first thing we want to learn about is what makes a reptile a reptile. So I'll run through some of this as revision. The main learning outcome for this video is to learn the names of the reptiles that live naturally in the United Kingdom and to learn a few bits about them. But let's start by reminding ourselves, what makes a reptile a reptile? So what I want you to do is repeat after me. Everything I call out in a minute are things that make reptiles reptiles. So repeat after me. Reptiles are alive. Reptiles are animals. Reptiles have skeletons. Reptiles have scales. Reptiles may have scales, but they aren't fish. So reptiles aren't fish. And finally, reptiles are cold-blooded. One more time. Reptiles are alive. Reptiles are not rocks. Reptiles are animals. Reptiles are not plants. Reptiles have skeletons. Reptiles have bones, including a backbone. Reptiles have scales. They have scales instead of fur or feathers. Reptiles are cold-blooded. Reptiles are called cold-blooded because they need to use the sun or things that have been warmed by the sun to get warm to have the energy to move around. So what are reptiles? So, there are some reptiles that live naturally in the UK. In fact, there are three kinds of snakes that live naturally in the UK, and there are three kinds of lizards that live naturally in the UK. And lizards and snakes are both types of reptile. So let's learn the names of the three kinds of snake that live naturally in the UK. The first snake we have is called the adder. And we're going to use a little game to help us remember these names. So the first type of snake is called the adder. So I want you to repeat after me, the awesome adder. The second snake that we have in the UK is called the smooth snake. And the way we're going to remember that name is by repeating after me, the secretive smooth snake. And the third kind of snake that we have living naturally in the UK is the grass snake. So I want you to repeat after me, the gorgeous grass snake. We also have three kinds of lizard that live naturally in the UK. And we're going to use the same method to help us remember their names. So firstly, we have the sand lizard. So I want you to repeat after me, the superb sand lizard. Next, we have the common lizard. So I want you to repeat after me, the clever common lizard. And finally, we have the slow worm. So I want you to repeat after me, the snake-like slow worm. So let's learn a little bit more about all the reptiles whose names we just learned. And we're going to start with the adder, or the awesome adder. So the adder grows to about 2/3 of a meter long, and it's quite a chunky snake. And the reason I think the adder is awesome is because it has a dark zigzag pattern that runs all down its back. Let's finish with a fun fact. Did you know the adder is the UK's only venomous snake, but adder bites are very rare. In fact, you're more likely to be injured whilst loading or unloading the dishwasher than you are by being bitten by an adder. So there's very little to worry about. Now let's learn a little bit about the smooth snake. So repeat after me, the secretive smooth snake. Now the smooth snake is a bit thinner than an adder, but it grows to about the same length, about 2/3 of a meter long. So moose snakes are grey or greyish brown, and they've got a heart-shaped crown marking on top of their heads like you can see in this picture. And the smooth snake name comes from the fact that its scales are flat and smooth. Now let's end with a fun fact about the smooth snake. They are the UK's rarest and most secretive reptile. They only live on a habitat called dry lowland heath, so they're very secretive. You're lucky if you ever spot one. Now let's learn a little bit about the grass snake. So can you repeat after me? The gorgeous grass snake. The grass snake is the UK's longest snake, and it can grow to over a metre in length. It's a greyish green colour, and it's got a distinctive yellow and black pattern just behind its head, where a shirt collar would be on us. It also has black bars down the sides of its body. Now a fun fact about the grass snake is that if they are cornered and want to escape, they can play dead, turning their bodies upside down and releasing a foul-smelling liquid. Yucky, but clever. Now that we've learned about the UK snakes, let's learn about the UK lizards. And let's start with the sand lizard. So repeat after me, the superb sand lizard. Sand lizards grow to be about 20 centimetres long with a stocky appearance. And the reason I call them the superb sand lizard is because they have really cool patterns across their bodies. The female is largely brown, but the male has green sides which are especially bright during the breeding season, like you can see in the picture. Now a fun fact about the superb sand lizard is how it gets its name. So sand lizards get their name from the fact that they need sand to lay their eggs. They dig burrows in sand, lay their eggs, and then cover them up, which keeps them safe from predators. When the baby lizards hatch, they push through to the outside world. Next, let's learn about the common lizard. So can you repeat after me, the clever common lizard? Common lizards are a bit shorter and a bit thinner than sand lizards. They grow to approximately 15 centimetres in length. They're normally a shade of brown with patterns of spots or stripes. A fun fact about common lizards is that snakes don't have eyelids, but lizards, like the common lizards, do. Lizards blink to clear their eyes and they close their eyes to sleep. Now finally, let's learn about the slow worm. So can you repeat after me, the snake-like slow worm? Now slow worms are a bit longer than the other lizards because they grow up to 40 centimetres long. And they are lizards, but they're often mistaken for snakes, and that's why I call them the snake-like slow worm. Have a look in the picture. Unlike snakes, they do have eyelids, and they do have a tongue that's shaped like a lizard's tongue. And even within their skeletons, they have bits that snakes don't have. Slow worms have a shiny appearance, and the males are sort of greyish brown, and some of the really old males can have bright blue spots. And the females are brown with dark sides, and some have a thin line down their backs. Now, a fun fact about the slow worm is that they can escape from predators by casting off their tail. So the detached tail continues to wriggle around, and this distracts their predators, which allows them to escape. Okay, so let's practice what we've just learned. We're going to practice by seeing if we can work out what type of snake or lizard is in the pictures that we can see on this slide. So let's start with the picture in the top left of the screen of the snake. Now that snake has a zigzag pattern down its back, and I think that zigzag pattern makes the snake quite awesome. So what would that be? That's the awesome adder. Now let's look at the picture of the snake in the middle on the left. It's got sort of a heart shape on its head, in its scales, and it's kind of a greyish brown colour, which I think makes it quite well camouflaged. So I think that's the secretive smooth snake. And finally, the picture of the snake at the bottom. you can see its head is sort of a greenish colour. That's very pretty. I can see also it's got sort of yellow bit just behind its head. Lovely yellows and greens. I think that is the gorgeous grass snake. Now that we've reminded ourselves of the names of the three snakes, let's remind ourselves of the names of the three lizards. So what about the lizard in the top of this slide? It's a really beautiful lizard. It's got really bright colours. And it's slightly bigger than the picture of the lizard underneath it. So I think that lizard with the superb green colour is the superb sand lizard. Now what about the middle image? That looks a bit smaller than the superb sand lizard. And it's a bit more of a simple colour, mostly brown. Now that one is definitely the clever common lizard. Ooh, but what about the lizard in the bottom right hand of this slide? That's very difficult because it doesn't look like a lizard. But what can it be? If it doesn't look like a lizard, if it looks more like a snake, but we know it's a lizard, that must be the snake-like slow worm. So now we're going to have a quick quiz to test everything that we've learned so far. So I want you to look at these three pictures of snakes and call out their names. So for every single picture here, call out the name of the snake that you think it is. I'll give you a minute to look at some of the features you can see, look at the way they look, have a think about what they are, and call them out. Well, the picture of the top snake has that awesome zigzag pattern. So we know the top snake is the awesome adder. Now the middle snake is a bit of a browny grey colour and it's got a pattern on its head that looks a bit like a heart. So that one is the secretive smooth snake. Now the bottom picture is of a greenish snake that's swimming. It's a really pretty snake. So that one is the gorgeous grass snake. Now let's see if we could do the same for the lizards with a quick quiz. So I want you to look at these images, look at some of the things you can see, and work out the names of the lizards in these pictures. I'll give you a minute to think about it and to call their names out. Okay, so the first picture at the top is of a really brightly coloured, superbly coloured, in fact, lizard. So we know that's the superb sand lizard. And the middle picture, which is a bit smaller than the sand lizard and is more of a brown colour, is the clever common lizard. And finally, the picture on the bottom of the lizard that actually looks quite a lot like a snake is the snake-like slow worm. Now let's finish with a quiz. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call out a question and I want you to shout out whether the answer is true or false. Every time I call out the question, shout out which one you think it is, true or false, and we'll see what we've learned. Question one. Six types of reptiles live naturally in the UK. True or false? Six types of reptiles live naturally in the UK. That one is true. There are three kinds of snakes and three kinds of lizards. Question two. Adders have a zigzag pattern along their backs. True or false? Adders have a zigzag pattern along their backs. That one is true. It helps them to blend in to their surroundings. True or false? Slow worms are a type of snake. True or false? Slow worms are a type of snake. That one is false. Slow worms do look a bit like snakes, but they're a kind of legless lizard. True or false? Sand lizards are bright red. True or false? Sand lizards are bright red. That one is false. Male sand lizards are green down their sides and especially bright green in their breeding season. True or false? Smooth snakes are our rarest reptile. True or false? Smooth snakes are our rarest reptile. That one is true. Smooth snakes are very secretive and hard to find, living only in a few places, and they are our rarest reptile. True or false? Common lizards are the biggest lizard in the UK. True or false? Common lizards are the biggest lizards in the UK. That one is false. In fact, sand lizards are slightly bigger than common lizards, and slow worms are even longer still. True or false? Grass snakes are the longest snake in the UK. True or false? Grass snakes are the longest snake in the UK. That one is true. Grass snakes can grow to be over a metre long, whereas adders and smooth snakes are slightly shorter. Well done. I want to finish by reminding ourselves of what we learned. The first thing we did is to check we remember what makes a reptile, and we've done that. And the second thing we did was to learn the names of the reptiles that live naturally in the United Kingdom and to learn a few things about them. And we've done that as well. So let's see if you could repeat after me one more time. The awesome adder, the secretive smooth snake, the gorgeous grass snake, the superb sand lizard, the clever common lizard, and the snake-like slow worm. Those are our three kinds of snakes and our three kinds of lizards. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions about anything you've learned, or if you have any questions about education programs related to reptiles, please don't hesitate to get in contact with me, and I've put my email on the slide here. Thank you.